In this video, we're gonna do mail merge using Gmail and Google Sheets and basically create an email template and send some emails using Google Sheets data. First, we're gonna need some data in Google Sheets. So I'll go to ChatGPT here, chatgpt.com, and I'll just ask for some data. Something like this should be good. So I'll just go ahead and copy this. Control C, Command C. Go here and paste it right there. And we have some data. Now you could format this with currency or something like that if you like, which I guess I'm gonna do. I'll click on this dollar sign. So now we have our data in our spreadsheet. Let's go ahead and name this tab. This one is called Sheet 1. I'm gonna double click and call this email data, I guess. Now at this point, the next thing we're gonna have to do is create our Gmail email template. So I'll go to Gmail using the same account and I'll compose a new email. So I'll click here. So now we can create our message. I'm gonna make this bigger. So I'm gonna leave this empty. Subject line is gonna be important here, so I'll just write email template as the subject line. Now later on, we'll talk about this subject line again, but for now, I'll leave it at this. So here, let's just create an email. Something like this. If you want to add some images or stuff, you can. As a matter of fact, let's actually do that. So I'll just go here and add some picture. So what I'll do, I'll just click on this insert photo and I'm gonna upload an image. Let's just drop something here. Should be good enough. Here we go. We have an image just so you can see what this is gonna look like. Maybe we'll just go ahead and make this smaller. So this is the actual message. So basically we just need this to be as a draft. And typically what happens as I start doing this, if I don't send anything, if I just close this window here under drafts, we'll see that email. And the subject line I did was email template. So now that we have this, basically there is a couple of things we have to do. First, we need to replace that first name and last names with this. And then our amount is gonna be this. And to do that, I'm gonna use this first line of headings. See how it says first name? So what I'll do, I'll go back here and open this template. And here, instead of John, I'm gonna do double curly brackets and then first name. And then close double curly brackets. So basically this first name is this column name right here. And then I'm gonna do the same thing for any other fields. So I'm gonna use last name and amount in this case. So I'll go here instead of this, we'll delete this. And of course I need a space there. I'm gonna do double curlies and then last name. Make sure that every character is exactly the same with spaces, extra characters, etc. So this is first name, last name, and then down here, we need amount. An amount is basically this column. So that creates the template I want. I'm gonna go ahead and close this again. So that we'll just leave here. That's our template with this special tags. Now we'll go back to our Google Sheets spreadsheet. So now we're gonna have to add some code, and luckily we have that code from documentation in Google. I'll link to this documentation page so you can copy anything you need to. So what I'll do here, I'll go to, first of all, extensions in this Google Sheets, App Script. There's no project name, so I'll just click here and name this project. And at this point, I'm gonna go to that documentation page right here, and I'm just gonna scroll down. This goes over a lot of details, but we're just gonna keep scrolling down until we get this source code. So I'm gonna open the source code, and there's this source code. So I'll just go ahead and copy this code, click on this copy button, go to my script and replace this with that code. So I'll just copy paste here. So I'll just save this, click on the save button or Control S, Command S. So let's scroll down and look at a couple of things. So if we scroll down, you can see on line 28 and 29, we have a couple of important things we have to set. One of them is the column name for emails, basically. This is gonna be where we're sending those emails. And if I go back to my spreadsheet, see that will be this column. It's called email. So I'll just use email here. Now for this one, we just need an empty column for this, which doesn't exist. And I'll name it exactly the same as this. I'll call it email sent. And I'll create a new column for that here. Maybe I'll make it bold to make it look similar. Maybe I'll just click here and use this paintbrush to use the same format. So this is just gonna be auto-populated with our script later. So we need the name of the column, which is that. And we need this emails column. This is where we're gonna be sending those emails. I'm gonna go back to the script, and here, this script is gonna create a menu in a spreadsheet. And then as we run this, it's going to open this pop-up that's gonna ask you to enter the subject line. So we'll get to it in a second. So for now, we don't really need to change anything else here. I'm just gonna go ahead and save this. And because this script is creating this menu, we need to basically make sure we save this and refresh this spreadsheet. So you wanna make sure you save this, because once I refresh the spreadsheet, it's gonna close this script tab. So I'm gonna close this myself. And then I'll go here and refresh this page. So once I refresh this, let's close this, you'll see now on top here, there's this new menu called Mail Merge. And then there is this Send Emails. Now, when I send this emails, it's gonna send it to these emails. Now, when I did that generation of data, it made all these different emails that don't actually exist. And I don't want to send this. Now, keep in mind, it's gonna be sending these emails out of your Gmail account. So you wanna make sure you're not spamming people when you do this. So what I'll do for now, instead of using these names, first of all, I'm just gonna cut this list down to less for now. And I'll just change this emails to, well, I'll just use the same email on this account for testing purposes so I can see what those emails look like, but eventually those are gonna be the actual emails. So for now, I'll just populate it with this account email. So now let's try to run this and see what happens. So I'm gonna go to Mail Merge, send emails. Now this account never ran any scripts to send any emails or to create any Google Sheets automation. So we're gonna have to give some permissions. So I'm gonna press okay. Now this is the account I'm using. Now, if you have a Workspace account, you're not gonna be looking at this, but since this is not a Workspace account and this is this test account, so I can show you how this works, I'm gonna click on this advanced. And here, I'm gonna go to this go to mail merge Google Sheets, which is the name of this file on safe. So I'll click on this. So basically it's just letting you know that you're giving permissions for the script to send emails on your behalf and to use your data in your spreadsheets. And I'm gonna click allow to do this. At this point now, that script actually runs. So for now, I'm just gonna cancel this because we did the permissions. Now, once that script runs, you can see it gave me that pop-up and it was asking me to populate something. And what it's asking me for is this subject line for this draft that I did. So when I did this, I did email template, because you could have multiple templates here and it needs to know which draft to use as a template. We need to use this one that's called email template in the subject line. So I'm going to go back here and click on this, send emails. And I want to make sure that I type that subject line exactly the same. And as you can see, it says copy paste subject line, which is probably a better idea so you don't mistype anything. So I'm going to press OK. And you can see finished. So I'm sending all those emails to this account. So at this point, we should be sending 3 emails to this account with this data. So let's go and take a look. So I'm going to go back to this and I'll go to my inbox. And it took a second, as you can see, but now we have all these emails that came through. And if you look at the first one, see if I click on this, see it has that Dear John Doe, and then here's your recent balance, 150, which is this number. So that's this first line, essentially. Now the next one should be this, like Jane Smith. So if I go back and we open this one, see, you can see Jane Smith and the balance is 120.50, which is this. And then the third one is, well, obviously all this data. You can see it did pick up the image for all of them. It does do that. If you add tables and all that type of stuff, it's still going to include anything you do. So the other thing here that may not be something you actually like is if I go back to my inbox, you're going to see that all these emails have the same subject line. So the subject line is email template. So as I'm sending these emails to, well, at some point to a whole bunch of people, I want those people to get an email with a certain subject line. So you have two options here. One, you can just have one subject line for all of them, which means when you create your draft and you enter the subject line, just use the actual subject line you want to send. And then when you go to run this here, enter that same exact subject line. And that way, that same subject line will be used for all these emails, and that will go through. So that's one option, and that's basically what the original script from this documentation here does. Now, let's assume that's not what you want. Let's say you want your subject line to change depending on your data here. So an example of that, maybe you want the subject line to be your new balance is, and then this number, and then this number, and then this number, and each one to get that subject line that way. Or maybe you want to include this category in it or something like that. So basically some data from here. So what I'll do for that, I'll actually create another column here called subject line. And by the way, before I do that, I want you to see that this email sent was populated with our dates. And this actually has both dates and times. So if I go here and do date and time formatting, you'll see exactly when those emails were actually sent out, which is great. But now let's take care of that subject line. So I'll do that actually before this column. So I'll add a new column. It doesn't have to be before, it could be after, but I'm doing it here. So I'll do subject. And what I'm going to do for the subject line, I'm just going to create it using concatenation to keep this simple. And for that, I'll start with equals, and in quotes, I'm going to type the text. So I'm going to say your balance is colon and space in quotes. If you're not familiar with how to use concatenation, I highly recommend you watch a separate video how to use concatenate. But here I'll just use the ampersand to concatenate, and I'll just use this 150. Now, because I'm doing a formula, it's going to pick up that number with no formatting. So this is what I'm going to get. And that may be okay, but I probably want this formatted like dollar signs and all of this. For that reason, I'll go back here and put this cell inside of a function called dollar. And basically, this function simply just adds that dollar formatting to your text. If I drag this down, you can see now we have our subject lines, which says your balance is this, your balance is, or it could be obviously anything. So now I want to pick up these subject lines as I'm sending those emails. And for that, we're going to have to modify our script a little bit. So I'm still going to leave this email template as a subject line here because we're going to have to pick up this draft using that subject line from here. But we'll go back to our script and make a modification. So I'll go back to app script. And let's scroll down a little bit. And this is basically the setup part on top. Now, this is where it's going to get that data from the spreadsheet. It gets the headers here. This one is getting the position for that email sent column. And as I keep scrolling down, at some point, we're going to see the actual loop here that actually sends those emails out, which is this. And right here for subject, it's using this, which is that subject line that we basically have for our Gmail template. So we're going to have to replace that with the actual data from that row. You can see here it says row recipient column. This is where those emails are being sent. This is that email sent column. Now we're going to have to also grab the subject. So what I'll do, I'll just scroll up and let's create another variable right here next to this too. So we'll do const. And here I'm going to call this subject col equals. And again, in quotations, we'll use the actual name from here. It's called subject. And that's how it's going to be able to find where that position of that column is. And then later in our code, we'll scroll down. And right here, instead of this, we'll use something similar to this. So we'll just copy and paste this here. And instead of this, we'll just use that new variable that's basically called subject col, which is the one we just made. So let's test this and see what happens. So I'm going to save this. And we'll go back and rerun this. Let me actually get rid of all this stuff. And let's go back and rerun this again. So I'm just going to go ahead and open this. We'll use this draft subject email template. Hit OK. Let's go back and take a look. So if I go back and take a look at our inbox, you'll see that everything appears empty here. Basically, the reason for that is going to be is that because we already have this email sent here, it will assume that this is already sent. There's no need to send it again. If we want to make sure it sends it again, we need to empty this email sent column, and I'm going to run it one more time. As you can see, this time it's taking a little bit more time because it has to actually send those emails. So now if I go back and take a look. So if you look here, now my subject line says your balance is 250.75 right here. I'm going to open this. That's the subject line. This, the rest of the message is exactly the same. It works fine. Now we can customize our subject lines too. And here you go. That's how we send mail merge-like emails using Gmail and Google Sheets data. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.